The U.S.-China relationship has deteriorated significantly over the last few years. When the time comes, which one will you choose?
I hope the time does not come. I mean, it is not possible for us to choose one or the other because we have very intense and extensive ties with both the U.S. and with China, economic as well as in other areas. And so too do many other countries in the world. So I don't think this is a dilemma only to Singapore. It's a problem for many countries in the world, which is why we are all hoping and encouraging the two large powers to think very carefully before embarking on deciding that the other one is an adversary and one which has to be kept down, if not put down.
What would it take, do you think, to get to a point where we see real military conflict between China and the United States? How likely is the possibility, do you think?
It's more likely than it was 5 years ago, but I think the odds of a military clash are not yet high. But the risk of severe tensions, which will raise the odds later on, I think that's considerable. Because both sides take their domestic calculations as paramount. What's their domestic position? How can they secure it? What must they do with their own populations? And their external relations are based on that. And therefore, it's not so easy to say, well, the external logic compels you to work together, because the internal logic may impel you to take a very hard line, and then you may find yourself at an impasse and clash. And that can easily happen.
Do you think the U.S. needs to accept that it's no longer number one?
I think the U.S. is still number one, but number two is not so far behind, and that's what is difficult for the U.S. to accept.
And when it comes to China, you know it very well.
I wouldn't claim that.
What I wanted to ask you is how concerned you are with the direction that China is taking politically.
Well, we cannot judge the domestic pressures which lead China to make the decisions it makes, but I think internationally the position which it has taken, it has won it some friends, but at the same time it has led to tensions with major powers, and there's significant uncertainty, anxiety over which way China is going and will this be good for them. And I don't think that is in China's interest.
So what do you think might be a better solution or a better way?
I would hesitate to give advice to other countries' leaders. I think they all make their own calculations. But what we would like to see is China being able to be a country where its prosperity and its development and its growing strength is welcomed by other countries in the world who see this as an opportunity for them to prosper together and to live in a stable world together. And even now, many, many countries, including Singapore, want very much to maintain good relations with China in order to benefit from China's development and to co-prosper with them. So I think that that is a very important factor which China has had in its favor, which it would be a pity to miss out on in the next phase. If you look at America, it used to be that the business people, American businessmen, MNCs, would be one of the strongest advocates for China and for good relations with China, because they saw the opportunities there, they saw how they could prosper there, they were investing there, they were trading. Walmart buys enormous amounts from China, and it benefits Americans, not just Walmart, but benefits American housewives and ordinary people all over the country. But in the last 5-7 years, I think American business attitudes have shifted, and they are now no longer as open in their support of China. In fact, there's quite a lot of pushback. It's not that the opportunities are not there, but they see that China has moved forward, and they want to see a more open environment and one where they get a bigger bite of the cherry. I think it's understandable. China is a new position now, and you have to make a different, set a different balance in your relationship with the world, and what the world was prepared to grant you in an earlier phase now has to be reworked. And that's quite difficult for a country to accept.
Indeed, and it makes it quite difficult for a country like Singapore that sits in the middle of all of this to navigate. When you do try and
yes.
navigate with these
yes.
big economic and political powers, what are some of your key considerations?
First, what is in Singapore's interest? How do we make a rational assessment of that and make that judgment for ourselves and hold our people together, persuade them that this is the right thing to do? And generally, it is that we want to be friends with both, but we have to find our right way, our own way forward. And from time to time, there will be kerfuffles. And we have had kerfuffles with China once in a while, with America also once in a while. And when that happens, you have to understand it cannot be helped between countries. This happens. It doesn't mean we are your opponent, but it does mean that we have problems which need to be worked through. And meanwhile, other areas where we can continue to work together. And that is how we do it.